It started when India-Pakistan used to play in Sharjah. And after some time, West Indies, Sri Lanka, England team used to also come and play. And I used to make a friendship with all the players, being very much interested in the game. And they used to give me sometime the bats, bowler will sign the ball, and they sometime like in a shirt. All this started a cap. And I had outhouse. An outhouse where it is a museum now. I had a small room which I converted gallery type. And very soon it got filled up. Now I thought I had to do something better and bigger. So I started working and building a proper cricket museum. And when I started, mind it, in this museum, there's no professional involved. Only me, my friends, and some cricketers who helped me. This roof idea you see now, I got, if you see the hotel at Bombay, Maratha Sheraton Hotel of ITC, the bar have a roof, something like this. The idea of this, you see the pillars, history of the game, and of the pillars, came from Sunil Gavaskar.
You may call it museum. You may, appreciate the archival value of this museum. But to me, it's university. You get to learn the kind of details, data, records, which is, for a student of cricket, is something that he can really, get knowledge in abundance if he visits this museum. The kind of record he has maintained, the kind of details he has preserved.
The way the sections have been made, so it makes it easier for anybody coming in for the first time, somebody who doesn't really know the game of cricket all that well, to be able to see and see for himself, how the game of cricket has progressed, the greats of a particular era, the following era, the next decade, etc. I think that has really been terrific. There's sections for bowlers, sections for batsmen, sections for all-rounders. And I think there's later on a section for limited overs cricket as well. And I think that takes a lot of effort, a lot of pain.
This is a museum of its own, because this is done by a particular individual who has his own taste, and he wants to put everything together and puts a lot of attention to it. He changes over things with respect to records and stats year by year, which is a remarkable achievement for someone who does it on his own.
I don't buy any memorabilia. All I have got is gifts. The bat you see, original autograph by Sir Don Bradman, was presented to me by my son on my birthday. And I use his shoes, the shoes of Graham Smith. When Graham Smith came to my museum, he was surprised what he saw. And he came next time, he brought his shoes. With these shoes, he played 100th test match and gave it to me. You see one helmet of, there's only one match between rest of the world and Australia. And this helmet is of rest of the world team, where Sunil Gavaskar was the manager. He surprises me and came and kept quietly here. Your helmet of Zahir Abbas. So like that, everybody come here and they love it. They send me their memorabilias, all these things. So it's an ongoing process now.
Nobody has supported him. He himself, spent each and every penny from his pocket. He visits throughout the world. He has been visiting throughout the world to watch the games of, the cricket of different countries, from his own expenses, from his own pocket. That kind of devotion, that kind of love he has got for the cricket.
For my museum, for my charity, I don't keep any accounts. I don't want to remember how much money I spent on this. I don't want to say, okay, after 10 years, after 5 years, I spent so much money on a charity, I made so much money on a my music. No.